Welcome. We would understand the various layers of the atmosphere. I have a diagram here, courtesy NASA. So what we are trying to understand here is the various layers. The lowermost layer of the atmosphere is known as troposphere. Now, troposphere is the region where you have the normal mountains, the normal phenomena of our day-to-day life that we see. Above the troposphere, you have the stratosphere. Stratosphere is the layer where you have the ozone that is present. Now, ozone basically prevents the harmful ultraviolet rays from reaching the Earth's surface. Ozone, when present in the stratosphere, acts or prevents the harmful ultraviolet rays. But this ozone, if present in the lower atmosphere, acts as pollutant. So that's again important thing to remember. In the stratosphere, the lower areas, you would have aeroplanes and aircrafts that could be seen. Above the stratosphere, you have mesosphere that could be seen. So this is the layer of mesosphere. Under mesosphere, you have the meteors or the shooting stars that could be seen. Above the mesosphere, you have thermosphere. And beyond thermosphere, you have the exosphere. So those are the common layers that we talk about. When we talk about thermosphere, you have most of the space stations that are located in the thermosphere, and in the exosphere you have the space shuttles, you have the Hubble. So all those are located in the exosphere. Phenomena like aurora borealis or aurora australis in the north and the south hemisphere are commonly seen in thermosphere. So these are the common layers of the atmosphere that we talk about. In the next class we would talk about ionosphere and magnetosphere and the difference between them and these layers. So stay tuned. Have a good day ahead.